Hello, mic test. Actually, I'm interested in extracting the real-time prices, right? Because most of the people are interested in that only. So I'll just scroll down a bit. Hello financial programmers, I'm Ritwik Dashora and I'm back with a new video and some new learnings. This is the second video of our playlist on Intrinio, which is a very reliable financial data provider. In the first video, we saw basics about this platform. We explored the entire website of Intrinio on the different types of data they provide. We also checked the documentation in brief. In this video, we will dig deeper into the documentation of Intrinio. We'll see all different types of data they provide. If you remember in the last video, I mentioned that you can actually get the extended version of the free trial of Intrinio by just talking to the team, by clicking on this button here and mentioning that you came from my YouTube channel. They say that you have a coupon code which is Ritwik, right? In that case, you will have a 1 month free trial of the data, which is enough for us to understand if it is good or not. I highly recommend you guys to do this because you won't be charged anything and you will get a chance of exploring such an amazing financial data provider. Perfect guys. So before anything, if you're new to my YouTube channel, on this channel, I turn all my viewers to successful financial programmers. Here I upload videos related to trading bots, implementation of AI in finance, using some highly valuable finance APIs like Intrinio, and making some Pine script trading strategies, etc, etc. So if this is something that you're interested in, then click on the subscribe button and also hit on the bell icon, because there are many more videos and playlists that are coming on my YouTube channel very soon for free. And I bet you that this one free click will be worth $1 million, because you are going to learn a lot on this YouTube channel. Okay, so what are the topics that we are going to cover in this video? We'll see how to use Intrinio Python API, right, which is SDK Python package, to extract the financial data. It is a very easy to understand SDK package. So yes, I think it will be very straightforward to you guys. I'll quickly give a summary of the last video on the different things that we explored. Right, then we'll start understanding the SDK Python package. We'll explore some of the APIs on Google Colab, and then I'll just provide a very basic information about the next video, which will be on the real-time stock prices data extraction in Python. So in the last video, we saw the documentation in very brief. This is the documentation page of Intrinio. If you click on Python SDK for Python, which is my favorite programming language, you'll see the basics about the installation, which is pip install Intrinio SDK and then import, and then they give an example of the code that we can directly use. But let's do one thing. Let's just directly jump to the GitHub page, because I think on GitHub it is much more explained, right? So let me just open the Google Colab. Okay, that's great. Now let me just name this as Intrinio video 2 code, right? So I'll come to this GitHub page, pip install Intrinio SDK. I'll just copy it, let's paste it here. It will automatically install Intrinio SDK package on Google Colab. Perfect, the Python package is installed now. Let's come back to our documentation, which is this one, right? Import Intrinio SDK, perfect. I'll just quickly jump to this particular segment, right? I'll copy this and let's paste it here, right? Here there are some of the things that I need to provide, which is my API key. So I'll just keep a cell here, which is API key is equal to, and then I'll paste my API key here. And rather than writing the API key here manually, I'll just refer to this particular variable. Perfect, I pasted my API key over there and ran that particular cell. So yeah, the API key is installed in this particular variable. Of course, I'm not showing it because of the privacy concerns. But yeah, let's see what different things we have. Import time, import Intrinio SDK as Intrinio, Intrinio SDK dot rest as API exception, and so on, right? So let's check all the different types of securities one by one, right? So what I'll do is, let's just delete this segment as of now, and also this section, I will just directly print it. Let's see, I'll remove this segment. Let's remove the segment as well. This is also not required. Only this thing is required, and I'll delete this segment as well. Let's explore all the APIs one by one here, right? We want we are actually checking the security API. So I'll just write security API here. You'll see a list of all the security API modules inside this particular class, right? So let's see this get all securities. Let's come back to our code and let's see if any inputs are required in this. No, there are no inputs required. If you run this particular cell, you'll see the entire information of all the different types of securities that we can actually use, right? You can see ETF information, we have some equities as well and so on, right? There's a lot of data here, so perfect. So that's one thing. Let's do one thing. I'll just copy this segment here and then replace this section again and again. Perfect. Let's come back to the other one. What other data should we extract now? Actually, I'm interested in extracting the real-time prices, right? Because most of the people are interested in that only. So I'll just scroll down a bit. Let's see real-time prices. Yeah, here we go. I click here. Let's see what if they have given any particular example of using real-time prices. So yes, this is the one, right? This is, I'll just copy from here. Let's copy here and paste it here. So I will have to provide the identifier, which is say AAPL source. Let's see what is source. Source is equal to source. It's bats. I'll just come here. I'll just provide bats here. Let's see what is the API response. Perfect. I don't have the access of this one. No worries. I'll just change it to say real time. Okay. I think I made another mistake, which is source is not a valid option. It must be IEX bats bat delayed. Let's see what is if we select the IEX as our source. Perfect. We have got it. So we have access to the IEX real time prices, and you can see the price of Apple is 193.98, and if you see in the real time, it is 193.98. Right. Just before that, guys, I have a very important information to share. Recently, I launched a course on Python for financial programming. So if you are trying to learn Python for finance from scratch, then this is something that you might be interested in. Just go to my website, which is fpritvik.com/Python. Over here, you will see two buttons, Indian candidates, non-Indian candidates. So you can click as per your location. It will redirect you to this, the main website where the entire course information is available. You'll see that there are 5 sessions, 10 chapters, 22 videos, 10 quizzes and 3 assignments with 2 live projects. And this is the entire syllabus of this course for all the people who are interested to learn Python from scratch and who are struggling learning Python on their own. I highly recommend it because it's very, very affordable, and I have covered a lot of things from a very, very simplistic eyesight. And in the end, in session 4 and 5, you'll see stock analysis and investment portfolio creation projects, which are my personal projects. We did it using some financial analysis. If you use RTK40 code, you'll get an instant 40% discount, which is only available for the first 100 candidates. So yes, guys, I'll see you in the course. Let's come back to our code. Let's explore the next function. I'll just copy and paste it again. Right now, let's jump to the documentation, which is this one, security API. Let's see the stock price, right? Yeah, this is the one, stock prices, get security stock prices. In order to get the historical stock prices of any particular security or ticker, right? They have provided all these types of all these things here. I will just copy this module and let's come here. Let's see what are different things required. Okay, get security stock prices. Inside this, I need to provide the identifier. Let's see, the identifier is Apple. Let's see, I'm not providing any other inputs, which is from or to date, right? So it will just give me some of the historical information of Apple. You can see adjusted close price, high, low, open volume, close, and all other 52 weeks high, low, etc. So this is a very simple way of extracting the data as well. You just need to write one line of code and that's it. Let's see what else. I found this get security insider ownership module really interesting. Let's see what it is. I need to provide the identify. Let's do MSFT in this case. Let's see what is the final response. Perfect. So it gives us information about the insider ownership. Let me just go to the top, right? Okay, so they have, it shows me the total amount change, amount percent change, no voting authority, owner name and other things as well. That's very, very interesting, right? Perfect. What else? Get security interval movers change, right? Inside this also, I didn't need to provide anything. I'll just run this. Perfect. We have this information as well. Now, very important, interval prices. For example, I want to get Apple's 15 minutes interval prices. In that case, I'll just write get security interval prices, right? Inside this, I need to provide the identifier. Let's do Tesla in this case, DSLA, comma, interval size. Inside this, I'll just write 15M, and yes, that's it. Let's run this cell, and let's see what is the final response. Invalid value for the source, it must be one of these things. So, okay, let me just write here. Source is equal to, let's copy this and paste it here. Let's see what is the answer now. Perfect, we have got the 15 minutes historical data, interval data of Tesla, right? What things do we have? We have the date time information, right? I think let's jump to the top here. It's 26th of January 2024 today, and right now it's 5:15 in the local time, right? So yeah, you'll see the 15 minutes interval data in front of you for Tesla. What information do we have? We have average price change, the close price, right? High interval, which is 15 minutes, low open time and volume in this particular 15 minute interval. Okay, so what else? Last thing, I'll just write get, and you'll see, yeah, I think I should cover this, which is get security price technicals, right? So it provides the technical indicators information as well. So for example, I'll just click on the security price technicals ATR, which is average true range, and here let's provide AAPL, comma, anything else required? Nothing. Let's run this and you'll see the ATR technical indicator numbers for different time periods, right? It's daily data here, 25th, 24th, 23rd and so on, and you have the ATR value here as well for Apple. And similarly, you can get the data for the other technical indicators information as well. So I think that's it for this video, guys. The main motive of this video was to explore the different types of APIs which are available on Intrinio. Again, as I mentioned at the beginning, make sure you are running the free trial in the beginning, because I don't want you to pay anything right now. And you guys should use the free trial before you are fully convinced on paying even 1 cent on anything. So if you're interested to get this particular code, guys, I'll save this particular code in my Google Drive. My already existing subscribers know that I share my Google Drive access with my Google Drive community members. Just go to YouTube, search Financial Programming with Ritvik, click on my channel, and over here, just click on this particular link, which is on the right hand side of my picture. It will redirect you to this particular post, which gives you all the step by step information about how you can become a Google Drive community member. It's fairly simple and it's very, very affordable as well. I charge a small amount of money because I hired a couple of interns to maintain the quality of the Google Drive content that we are providing to the community members. And also this way you will be supporting my work as well. If you liked even one thing about this video, guys, click on this like button because it really helps with the algorithm. And also click on the subscribe and on the bell icon, because as I mentioned in the beginning, there is a lot of content that will be available on my YouTube channel very soon. I upload videos every Saturday. So yes, that's completely worth it. In the next video, I will talk about extracting the real-time prices using WebSocket of Intrinio, and the data source would be IEX to your laptop on Python. So it's fairly simple. I'm very excited for the next video. For any freelance work, please reach out to my team on this email address and they will write to you as soon as possible. And yes, guys, check out my course on Python for Financial Programming. It's made for beginners. If you know Python, then don't click on the link in the description section. If you are someone who is willing to learn Python from scratch, then this is for you. Thank you so much, guys, for watching this video till the end. You can click here to subscribe to my YouTube channel. Over there, you'll see this entire playlist on Intrinio, and over there, you'll see my video on MT5 trading bot that I made a few weeks ago. Keep learning, keep financial programming, and I'll see you in the next video very, very soon. Till then, peace.